guys. I'm going to play on this a little bit more because, you know what, it's a new year. I might as well do it. We're going to talk about 2021. Who will survive 2020 as a world champion? I don't know if I'll be able to do it all in one video. I'm just going to ramble on here about who I think is going to survive and who I don't think is going to survive. So if it goes longer than probably 5 minutes, we'll probably make this into two parts. But if we get them all through, then we're good. So let's start at the heaviest division in the men's category, the heavyweight division, which Stipe Miocic is the king of going into 2020. Now, do I think Stipe Miocic will hold the belt throughout 2020? If I'm going to have to say, I'm going to have to say yes. I think Stipe Miocic will end 2020 a world champion in the heavyweight division. It's going to be interesting to see how many fights he gets. I think he might only have to go through one opponent. If he has to go through two, my opinion might change, as I think Francis is ultimately going to be the world champion in that division. But if he only fights Daniel Cormier and then maybe has to fight somebody in December, maybe he'll hold through. You know what? I'm actually going to switch it up. I'm going to say no. Because honestly, I think Daniel Cormier has a good shot of dethroning Stipe Miocic. And I think that he's still going to get a fight in December. And if he gets a fight against Francis, he's not surviving that guy twice. Francis Ngannou is something different. I think this one's going to be a controversial opinion. But at 265, I think we're going to have a new world champion. Let's get to men's light heavyweight. Now, the real question for me here, I think John Jones, if he stays at light heavyweight, is going to stay the world champion. But will he move up to heavyweight and be forced to vacate the 205 strap? That's the big question here. He fights Dominic Reyes early in the year, so that will leave him lots of time to get to December, wait for the Stipe Miocic, Daniel Cormier winner, and decide if he wants to move up. Now, I don't think there is really a top contender that's going to strip. They're going to strip John Jones. They might do an interim title in 2020, but I don't think that they're going to strip John Jones completely. And I think John Jones is going to win all his fights in 2020. So I'm going to go with 205 light heavyweight division. John Jones survives, stays world champion. Now we got middleweight Israel Adesanya. Now he's going to have to go through an absolute killer's row if he wants to go through the stretch. He wants to fight Yoel Romero first. Then he'll have to go on to fight Paulo Costa. Now that is a hellish 2020 campaign for any man to go through. Adesanya is a superstar nonetheless. So will he be able to continue as a champion in 2020? This one is probably going to be the toughest one for me. As I'm high on Paulo Costa, I'm high on Yoel Romero, and I'm not high on a guy who has to fight both of them in 1 year to defend his belt. So with this one, I think again controversially, I do think Israel Adesanya is going to be world champion at the end of 2020. This one's tough for me, though. That one's an interesting one because he's going to have to go fight Yoel Romero. I trust the New Zealand camp a good amount, but it's going to be so, so tough. And I'm just going to go, this one's like 50-50. Maybe even I'm betting the underdog here, but I'm taking Israel Adesanya to stay world champion in 2020. Now 170, I think this is a little bit easier. Kamaru Usman's going to remain world champion of 170-pound division. He just went through Kobe Covington, who I thought was going to be his toughest challenge. Unless he gets freak knockout by like a Jorge Masvidal, Leon Edwards, I think Usman is going to remain world champion throughout this year. I think that he'll have probably a pretty dominant reign as welterweight champion. It's crazy how many people went into 2019 as a champion and didn't leave 2019 as a champion. But I think we're going to get a couple more, a couple of stabler divisions here this year. So we're going to say Kamaru Usman remains world champion. Now we're down to men's lightweight, 155. Khabib Nurmagomedov will ultimately be defeated by Tony Ferguson. Tony Ferguson's going to be the world champion of what? No, I don't know. This one's fucking tough too, man. They're both savages. This is going to be a great fight. One of the most anticipated fights as an MMA fan I think I've ever had. I'm going to say Khabib Nurmagomedov wins the fight against Tony Ferguson. I want Tony to win so badly, but mind over heart, I'm going to go with Khabib. I think Khabib is going to remain the lightweight champion through 2020, and I think that he's probably going to retire in 2021. Keep that in mind when in 2021 Khabib retires, and I'm right. Let's move on again. Alexander Volkanovski, 145. I do not think he is going to remain world champion. I think he is going to have a very active 2020. I think he's going to run into either the Korean Zombie. He's going to run into somebody that's going to be able to take him down or somebody that's going to be able to land a shot. I like Volkanovski, but I don't think that he will remain world champion through 2020. We got men's bantamweight, Henry Cejudo. I don't see anybody beating Henry Cejudo at bantamweight. I think he's going to remain world champion. whether he moves up to 145, I don't think it's going to be this year. I think ultimately Henry Cejudo will move up to 145. But at this point, I think the formerly known Triple C, now basically Double C, is going to remain bantamweight champion. We're going to get a lot of cringe throughout the year. Then for flyweight, we actually don't have a champion right now. We go into 2020 without a champion. Joseph Benavidez is going to get that belt against what the fuck is his name? I did a whole video on this fucking shit. Benavidez is going to win the belt this year, and he's going to defend it once more at the end of the year because Joseph Benavidez loves to fight. He loves to stay active. So I'm going to say he is going to remain world champion. Then at women's featherweight, we have Amanda Nunes with featherweight and bantamweight, and I think she's going to stay the champion in both those divisions. Barring maybe she retires at some point because she's just killing everyone. I think that Amanda Nunes is going to stay world champion. People have been teasing a Shevchenko versus Amanda Nunes 135 bout for that belt. If that fight goes down, it's going to be a very, very interesting one. But I think I'm going to stick with Amanda Nunes in both those divisions, just as I'm going to stick with Valentina Shevchenko in the 125-pound division at the end of 2020. I think Shevchenko is going to be the world champion at flyweight. And again, another woman's weight division with a current champion that I think is going to survive 2020 as world champion, Zhang Weili. That girl, man, fucking, she's a savage. Nobody's beating her. Bro, she's like 21-1. She's stopped everyone. Oh, just dominated everyone throughout her career. Maybe her toughest fight was Tisha Torres, but the way she just brutalized Andrade in her home country was just ridiculous. She's going to be a superstar in 2020. I think she's going to sleep Joanna Jędrzejczyk, but we're going to have to find out later on in the future. Let me know what you guys think about my picks down below in that comment section below. Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? Give me your entire list of who's not going to remain champion. In the comments, I want you to say who's going to be the champion of each division. Let me know that in the comment section below. But that'll do it for me today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I think this is going to be the end of the 2020-2019 New Year content. But if you guys enjoyed, make sure to smash that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Turn on notifications so you stay with us throughout 2020. And you can beef me if I'm wrong. Bow down if I'm right. But that'll do it for today, guys. Peace out.